Hi, I'm Saul Goodman. Did you know that you have rights? The Constitution says you do, and so do I.
So if you want to make more money and keep the money that you make, better call Saul.
Hey, Francesca, how about I follow you home?
No.
For safety. What? God, you are killing me with that booty.
Like a troll under a bridge, you must send the stickers or you won't pass. Troll alert here.
Believe me, there's no honor among thieves. Except for us, of course.
Someone like that?
Let's just say I know a guy who knows a guy. Who knows another guy. Zombies. I got a guy who knows this guy, who knows this Rain Man type, right? He lives with his mother in her basement in Belarus. Next time, plan for it, would you? Starship Enterprise had a self-destruct button.
Rupert Holmes, that's who the documentary is about.
I'm sorry, who?
Rupert Holmes. You know, Rupert Holmes, the singer-songwriter. You know, the Pina Colada song. I mean, sure you do. If you like pina coladas, getting caught in the rain, if you're not into yoga, and you got half a brain, if you like making love at midnight, in the dunes by the Cape, see? Look at her face, Rupert Holmes.
He went to school here?
Yeah, class of 64, he still talks about it.
But the school was built in 71.
He was a student in the old building that used to be here. We're taking a little, what do you call it, artistic liberties.
Isn't Rupert Holmes English?
Well, yeah, and that's some great trivia. But he spent his formative years right here in Albuquerque.
Paging Dr. Phil, my daddy's a drug dealer, and my mommy turned him in. Let me tell you something. If you're committed enough, you can make any story work. I once convinced a woman that I was Kevin Costner, and it worked because I believed it. Right? It has nothing to do with the story.
Hey.
Hey.
You are not Kevin Costner.
I was last night.
Bad idea. This is a bad idea.
So.
Take a break, HT, let's go.
You're gonna stop calling me that or I'm gonna hang you by your tie.
Yeah, yeah, stop showing off for the client. Honey tits.
Christ. Some people are immune to good advice.
Clearly his taste in women is the same as his taste in lawyers, only the very best, with just the right amount of dirty. That's a joke. That's a joke.
Hey, how you doing?
You're on our billboard. You're the lawyer guy, yeah.
Better call Saul.
What happened to your face?
This is, guess you call it an occupational hazard.
Okay, so thank you. And please give that to your car wash professional.
Very good. Thank you very much. Good to meet you.
Yeah.
Don't drink and drive. But okay. If you do, call me.
Christ, you too.
All I can say is if I ever get anal polyps, I'll know what to name them.
We're all on the clock here, and thanks for that, by the way. You two want to go stick your wangs in a hornet's nest. It's a free country, but how come I always got to get sloppy seconds, huh?
I need you to pick up that bag and get it to me as soon as possible.
You know how thick the crap storm is out there because of this? I told you not to use that lawyer. He's a hack.
Shut up, Saul, and get the bag.
He's right about that TRO. It's going to get tossed. Toot sweet. Meanwhile, Schrader's hard-on for you just reached Uncle Milty proportions, so have fun with that.
Agent Schrader, beat any good suspects lately? Tall and taller, ask him about his history with my client. He knocked the poor kid unconscious last time they were alone together.
Okay, but say, you know, just for the sake of argument, the kid's not in the mood for a nuanced discussion of the virtues of child poisoning. You know, his plans are running more towards stabbing you to death with a pointed stick. In that scenario, then what?
The job offer, it didn't upset me. It amused me. Big job at the illustrious HHM. Chance to play at the palace. Little old me? You have no idea what's going on. You're a teensy tiny man in a teensy weensy little bubble.
Oh, Jimmy.
Oh, don't you fucking old Jimmy me. You look down on me, you pity me. Walk away. That's right, Howard. You know why I didn't take the job? Because it's too small. I don't care about it. It's nothing to me. It's a bacterium. I travel in worlds you can't even imagine. You can't conceive of what I'm capable of. I'm so far beyond you. I'm like a god in human clothing. Lightning bolts shoot from my fingertips.
Mr. McGill, you're still here. There's some good news.
Believe me, I already know.
Oh, good. Then if you want to come with me to the office, there's some paperwork for you to sign.
Absolutely. Let's do this thing. Oh, and sweetheart, I'm going to need one more form. DBA. Because I'm not going to be practicing under the name McGill, so.
Shouldn't be a problem. Just down the hall, we have all the forms.
Great.
Wait, Jimmy, what?
It's all good, man.